What do you need to know before you become a house sitter? I'm a house sitter, and before I even became a member and became a house sitter, there's several things that I wish I knew. So that's what this video is all about. My name is Rachel Smets, and yes, I am traveling the world in beautiful locations, and I am a house sitter. But right before the house sitting, these are a few things that you should know. First things first. Before the first step, make sure that you genuinely love animals. If you don't care about animals, don't even get started about it. It's really important. You will be house sitting, pet sitting, cats, dogs. You don't have to love all animals. I don't like farm animals, but yeah, cats, dogs, birds. Make sure you like animals. Otherwise, don't even go there. But then comes step number one. Step number one is ask other house sitters. That's how I start. Ask other house sitters. Ask them questions. What did you do? Where are you? How is it like? What is your experience? Do you have any good experiences, any bad experiences? Just mingle with some other house sitters. They are so easy to find. Just go on Facebook, go on Google. There's so many groups out there on Instagram, Facebook, social media. You can find them easily. So just try to connect a little bit with other house sitters before you even continue. Step number two, go and search websites. Now, this is something I wish I knew, because the first time I Googled house sitting, there is a ton of house sitting websites. Which one do you choose? Then I figured out, there's house sits websites for particular regions. You just want to stay within Europe? You just want to stay within the US? Then choose those companies, those websites. For example, there is Kiwi House Sitters, clearly only for those in New Zealand. There is Aussie House Sitters for Australians. There are European, Asian ones. There's plenty out there. And I chose an international one, Trusted House Sitters. By the way, I'll put the link right below this video. Why? It's international. If I want to stay close to home, I can find house sitting jobs. If I want to go further away, I can do the same too. So search some websites. Know that you can be region-specific, content-specific, or not. It's up to you. There are smaller websites and bigger websites. That means that some of them have a lot of lists of house sittings and house owners. Some of them, not so much. So there is a debate, and some people will tell you, well, start small and pick a small one that doesn't have too many because you have more chances to get a house sitting job. Some people say, no, go bigger. So take those who have a lot of house sits, you have more chances. It's up to you. What did I do? I chose a little one and I chose a big one and I became a member of two so that I increase my chances, and I'll talk about the competition in a moment. Step number three, make a decision which house sitting website do you choose and become a member. Like I said, I chose Trusted House Sitter and House Sit Match. House Sit Match because it's smaller. And I thought maybe I can, you know, there's a good customer service as well, and I can maybe have a house sit easier. And then Trusted House Sitter, I'll put the link right below. There's a ton of house sits out there. So I thought, I can choose wherever in the world I want to go. Step number four, you become a member, you pay the membership because yes, they ask for a membership, and then you create your profile. But it's not just putting up a picture and your name. It's more than that. And also that I wish somebody would have told me. Because you have to have at least one reference. One reference that you've done a house sit successfully or a pet sitting job. But luckily it can be a family member, a friend. You can find anybody who can give you a reference. And maybe you have references. So they have to write a reference. Second thing is, when you put up your profile, you have to go through a police check or, well, a criminal record check. And that's good to know, because you need that, and I guess it's a good thing, because then, you know it's safe, you know it's trusted. And the last step, number five, is go on there, search and apply for house sittings. And to create a good profile that is successful, and to be successful in receiving applications, it's another story. So if you want to know more about that, I'll create another video on that, so just put it in the comments below. But for now, that's it. You can get started And I wish you all the best of luck because the experience is amazing. Remember, if you like this video, subscribe to my channel and live the dream life abroad. That's how I help people. See you in the next video. Bye.